Hi guys, I'm Chris Egnoto, and I guess you're on my YouTube channel, so thanks for watching. And today, we're going to find some dusky salamanders. I'm in kind of central western New Jersey right now, and this is a spot where I just find dusky salamanders all over the place. So let's find some. Keep in mind, if you ever handle these guys, please be sure to wet your hands first. You don't want to burn them with your skin. And it also makes it difficult for them to breathe and all that kind of stuff. They need that protective mucus on their skin. When you touch them with dry hands, it kind of ruins it for them. Let's get going. Okay, here's a dusky salamander right here. These guys are pretty awesome. In fact, let's start with this one first. This is a northern two-lined. Great example. These guys often share the same habitat. Okay, there is a northern two-lined salamander. Okay, take a look at him. That's northern two-lined, right? Pretty fast. They got those lines going down their sides. And right there is the dusky. You can already tell the dusky is bigger. You know, the duskies I find around here are usually quite large. And they're broader. Okay, they have a stouter body. You know, much broader, fatter legs, and all that kind of stuff. Now, the dusky often can be like orange, kind of an orangey color, or gray. Okay, so the dusky is usually kind of a reddish, orangish color. Or gray. As they get older, they get duskier. Look at that go. These guys are so hard to film because they never stay put. But if you look behind the eye, you've got that white line behind its eye. It's a great indicator that it's a dusky. They all pretty much have that. Now this one's older, so it's got more of a gray uniform color, which is very normal for the duskies. If you look closely, you can see some reddish still left on this guy, but he's pretty much full grown. Now their body is a little speckled, their bellies. See that? That's kind of a good angle there for a second. As I said, they live side by side with the two-lined salamanders. These guys like to be near streams, shallow streams, and you know, the edges around the streams. But when it comes time for breeding, these guys are pretty neat because they don't lay their eggs in water, okay? They'll lay their eggs outside of water, either in dry stream beds, you know, and in nooks and crannies, or under rocks and logs. And then the mom, she'll stay beside the eggs. She'll stay next to the eggs, okay? Now, the mother will stay next to the eggs, keeping them moist and protecting them. Okay, from predators and things like that. The neat thing about these guys, right, is one, they lay their eggs and stuff like midsummer to fall. So a lot of other salamanders, they're either in the spring, which is most of them, or in the fall. These guys are like in the summer. It's pretty interesting. And the babies only take about a year to develop, which is pretty fast for these guys. Okay, it's pretty fast for a salamander. You might notice that when these guys move around, or when they flee, they wiggle like a fish or an eel or something, you know, it's just real fast. They barely use their legs, but they never stay put. They don't like to be out in the sunlight, and they sure don't like to be handled, you know. They don't get too upset, they don't try to bite you or anything, but they sure try to flee. Really difficult to film this, so I apologize for some of the video quality, but we do the best we can, right? Now look at their tail. Look how the tail is slightly keeled, right, which means it's slightly flat. So it's really good for propulsion in the water, okay? These guys will definitely propel themselves rather rapidly. I'm sure you've already seen that in some of my clips. One more thing I forgot to mention about these guys is when they lay their eggs, they're usually in grape-like clusters. Anywhere from one to say three dozen eggs, That's about as many as they'll lay, up to about 36. And they'll be, as I said, in a grape-like cluster. So this is the northern dusky salamander. These guys like to eat the same kind of stuff as other salamanders, right? Soft-bodied insects, sometimes hard-bodied insects, snails, slugs, worms, okay? And maybe even the odd juvenile salamander here or there. Northern dusky salamander. See that stripe, that reddish stripe down their back? It's usually kind of characteristic. Sometimes it's more defined, sometimes it's less defined. So there we go. Maybe in the future I'll get a better video of these guys when Ivy comes along with me and I get to hold them. She'll hold the camera. But in the meantime, that's my video for the northern dusky salamander. That storm's about to hit pretty soon, so I'm gonna head home and charge my stuff up. See you later, guys. Thanks for watching. I'm Chris Egnoto.